हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर मीनाक्षी माउर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर जूलॉजी, श्री सांवला जी गवर्नमेंट कॉलेज, मंडफिया, चित्तौड़गढ़। टुडे माय टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज सेरिकल्चर। सेरिकल्चर इज एग्रो बेस्ड इंडस्ट्री। इट इन्वॉल्व्स रियरिंग ऑफ सिल्कवॉर्म्स फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ रॉ सिल्क। और सेरिकल्चर इज ऑल्सो नोन एज सिल्क फार्मिंग। इट इंक्लूड्स द प्रोसेस ऑफ मेकिंग सिल्क फाइबर्स एंड इट स्टार्ट्स बाय रेजिंग सिल्क वॉर्म एंड देन दे प्रोड्यूस फाइबर्स विच आर प्रोसेस्ड एंड कंबाइंड इन टू सिल्क थ्रेड। मोस्टली बॉम्बिक्स मोरी, विच इज़ अ डोमेस्टिकेटेड सिल्क वॉर्म, इज यूज फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ सेरिकल्चर। The main aim of sericulture is to rear the silkworm by providing them optimum conditions and mountages so that they can spin good cocoon with high and best silk content. There are four types of silk mainly: mulberry, airy, munga and tussar. Mulberry is a top quality silk which is shiny and creamy white in color. It is produced by silkworm Bombyx mori. Bombyx mori feeds on mulberry, that is a Mora alba tree. Then airy. Airy is a moderate quality creamy white fiber, but they are less shiny. They are produced by the species Atticus ricini, which feeds on Ricinus communis, it is a castor. Then munga silk, its color is light yellow and it's a tough fiber and it's of moderate quality. It is produced by silkworm Anthera asama. It feeds on Tetraanthera monotella and plants like Listeria citrata. Then tussar silk, it is a copper brown in color and it is of the lowest quality. It produced by Anthera mylita or by Anthera papia, Anthera royali or Anthera perennini. They feeds on plants like Gigipus zuzoba, which is a plum tree. Now history. Actually, there is no authentic information regarding the origin and the use of silk, but there are two views according to ancient literature. First view says that silk industry originated in India at the foot of Himalayas, and from Himalayas it spread to the other countries of the world. But there is also second view, which says that industry originated in China about 3000 BC ago. A Chinese prince, Shiling Chai, was the first to discover the art of reeling an unbroken filament from a cocoon. This art was kept a close secret for about 3000 years, but later on spread to the rest of the world through civil war, refugee, war prisoners, marriage of royal families, etc. There is also one more view which says that Lao Tzu, Empress of Kuang Tai, from China, discovered this fancy silk in the form of thread. Now, sericulture process. It includes three primary steps: moriculture, silkworm rearing, and silk reeling. Moriculture means cultivation of mulberry leaves. Silkworm rearing, which promotes the growth of silkworm. And silk reeling means extraction of silk filament from the silkworm cocoons. So these are the three steps which we'll discuss in detail. First is moriculture. It refers to the cultivation of mulberry plants. Why? Because silkworm feeds on mulberry leaves. Their main food is mulberry leaves. And these plants can be grown by three different methods. First is cultivation from seeds, root grafting, or stem grafting. After the plants grown, the mulberry leaves can be harvested from the plants by the following methods. First is leaf picking, which means removal of individual leaves by hand. Second is branch cutting, which involves removal of the entire branch and then extract leaf from these branches. And last, top shoot harvesting, which means removal of mulberry shoot tops. Now, silkworm rearing, which is the second step of sericulture. What does it involve? It involves rearing process of silkworm. There are seven steps: disinfection, brushing, feeding the larva, spacing, bed cleaning, caring during molting, and mounting. First, disinfection. Disinfection means disinfection of everything. Every instrument, every equipment, places, and most important, rearing place. It can be done by three methods: physical, chemical, and radiation. Physical method includes sunlight, steam, and hot air. Chemical means chloramine, formalin, and radiation method includes radiations. Now, brushing. Brushing means when newly hatched larva from the eggshells are transferred to rearing tree. This process is known as brushing. Now, third step is feeding the larva. It includes preparation of feeding bed on a rearing tree. It can be done by sprinkling chopped mulberry leaves. Chopped mulberry leaves is the food of silkworm. Fourth step is spacing. It includes extending rearing spaces at each stage of the sericulture, which make available more and adequate space to growing worms. Because in rearing rate, there is a crowded situation, which can increase humidity, heat, fermentation of litter, and food wastage. So to avoid all these bad things or inappropriate situations for growing silkworm, we prefer spacing. Now, bed cleaning. Bed cleaning means removing litter periodically from rearing tree, which is important for growth of worms. Now, caring during molting. It includes stopping, resuming feeding at appropriate time, which ensure in uniform growth of the silkworm. It also includes disinfection and keeping bed dry. Now, mounting. When the ripe worms are transferred to the mountages, the process is known as mounting. On the mountage, the ripe worms exude silk, spin the cocoon around itself, and transferred into pupa inside it. Mounting can be done by several methods like hand picking, net method, and branch method. So final stage of sericulture is the harvesting of silk from cocoon. Now, silk reeling. There is a two main important process in silk reeling is a stifling and reeling. Stifling means process of killing pupa inside the cocoon by boiling the cocoon and exposing it to steam and dry heat. Actually, it reduces the addition of silk thread and enables separation of filaments. Now, reeling. The process of removing silk filament from the dead cocoon is known as reeling. When the filaments are separated, they are twisted into thread with the help of series of guides and pulley. When we get silk, it is then reboiled in order to improve its luster. Finally, the silk filaments are woven together to form a threat, which are often plied together to form a yarn or a cloth. The raw silk is obtained from the silkworm and the sericulture process is completed. So it is a whole process, you can see in this diagram. These are the pupa which are being killed in hot water. Now wheel is used to separate the threads. So it is a diagram which showing whole process of sericulture. Here egg laying, egg hatching, and these are worms and which are feeding on mulberry leaves. Mulberry leaves we are getting from mulberry plants. When silkworm feed on mulberry leaves, they grow and they form cocoon. When cocoon is formed, moth is emerged. But the cocoon is used for reeling and spinning, by which we get raw silk. Now raw silk is processed and twisting, degumming and dyeing is done. After this process done, the weaving of silk fabric is done. So it is a whole sericulture summary. Now there are some diseases of silkworm which are very harmful for sericulture industry. So we have to take precaution so that worms do not get any diseases. Actually, sericulture industry suffers from number of diseases in tropical region of Southeast Asia and cause severe damage to industry. So first is a maggot, which is caused by Trichologa sorbulus. It is a type of fly. The presence of milky white cylindrical eggs on the skin of silkworm larva is a symptom of this disease. Now piperine. It is caused by Nosema bombensis. It is a microsporidia, means microorganism. It's the worst disease of silkworm. When new spores are formed in the tissue of alimentary canal of silkworm, they are discharged with the feces and make a source of infection. Actually, in this disease, larvae show little inclination towards food and exhibit irregular and differential growth, which results in the formation of small larvae of different sizes, and they become tardy, shrunken, or mold quite late and finally die. Now, polyhidrosis. It is caused by virus. There are three types of polyhidrosis in silkworm: nuclear polyhidrosis, intestinal cytoplasmic polyhidrosis, and intestinal nuclear polyhidrosis. And then flatulia, it is caused by bacteria. Actually, symptoms include loss of appetite, translucent cephalothorax, vomiting, and diarrhea in silkworm. Now, last, green muscularine. It is caused by fungus. The infection may be observed at the third and the fourth stadia of silkworm. In the beginning stage, a big black spot is observed on the ventral side. So these are the diseases of silkworm, and we have discussed the whole process of sericulture. So thank you.